The GCN Tech Clinic gets loads of questions all about Freehubs, so I thought it was about time we actually go through exactly what they are and how they work. Now, the purpose or job of the Freehub is not just to actually carry your cluster of sprockets. It is in fact to allow you to transfer the power from your legs through to the rear wheel to drive you forward. And importantly, an added feature of it is to allow you to freewheel too, which is pretty important, let's face it. Now, a Freehub isn't actually permanently attached onto the actual hub shell of your wheel. Instead, they're normally held in place via the axle, so you can simply slide them on or off. Although it's not always that easy, in some cases it is, because you can just pop off the end caps. But on other ones, you actually just have to put a couple of 5mm Allen keys in, or maybe a 17mm open-ended spanner, undo them, then you can slide off that Freehub body. If you're unsure about it, do check the manufacturer's website, because normally you'll get quite comprehensive technical guides on there. However, one thing certainly to bear in mind is when you do remove the Freehub from the actual hub shell itself, is to do it very slowly and normally over a surface where you're not going to lose anything, because, well, you'll see quite soon exactly why. Now, some Freehubs are totally sealed and can't be serviced or maintained in any way. So generally, those are found on wheels like some Shimano's, some older Fulcrums or low-end Campagnolo, that sort of thing. However, in the past, I have actually taken them off of a hub, dumped them into a vat of oil for a couple of weeks, taken them back out, and they've worked okay, but only temporarily. So if you do have one, really, I'd save all of that fuss and just go and buy a new one. First up then, let's have a look at how a 3 or 4 pull mechanism works. This one on this Vision is a 3 pull. So here we've got them, 1, 2, and 3. Sometimes you get a 4 or 6 even, but they're just evenly spaced out around the edges there. Now these ones are actually held in place. There's a little snap ring around the edge of the actual Freehub here. And if I lift that up, it means I can actually take those pulls out and I can service them, remove any of that dirt in there. Sometimes these pulls are held in place just simply with little springs, tiny, tiny little springs. Now that's why it's important not to lose any, because they're so small, it's unlikely you'll find them if you do it on your carpet or something. So the way they work is they're angled in such a way that they match up with the inside of the actual hub shell here. So they're almost like a reverse angle of it, so that when they slot in, when you're driving down the power, it drives the hub around. And likewise, when you freewheel, they're able to actually just flop back into position, and that's what makes that tickety tick noise inside of the hub. So I just thought I'd show off this design too. So it, likewise, it is a 3-pull mechanism, but it's exploded. It's nicely cut away so we can actually show what's going on here. So we've got the 3 pulls on the Freehub here on the rear, and they're held in place, like I said before, with tiny little springs as well as a retaining ring. But then interestingly on this hub, you've got 12 little notches on each pull. And then inside the actual hub shell here, pressed into place, is a ring, so it's like a drive ring almost for these pulls to sit in, and there you've got 120 different points of engagement. So each one has got 12, so you've got 36 points which are going to be engaging all at the same time on, well, 36 out of 120 of the little slots inside. Now compared to the 24 inside of that Vision, it may well sound like this is the ultimate hub, but well, you're not actually going to get any benefits really or performance increases in my opinion from that. But one thing it has got, listen to this noise. Pretty cool. We'll do a full Freehub sound test later on though. Now Mavic wheels, they work different again. Although some of the newer ones, they work fairly similarly to the DT Swiss ones. But this one on this Axiom wheel, I'm gonna take it off very carefully and you'll see why. Hopefully nothing comes off. But they work almost in the reverse way of that first Freehub setup that we looked at, so the 3 or 4 pull mechanism. So these ones are actually attached onto the hub body or axle almost of the hub and held in place again with tiny little springs there. And those little pulls, they actually engage into the slots inside of the freehub body. So just like I said at the start, they work almost in reverse. And then obviously when they engage with those slots inside of the freehub body, it's the spring tension of these tiny little springs that always amazes me, that they can just pop essentially all of the power from your legs back into place to drive you forward. It's amazing, that. So next up is another type of ratchet mechanism. This one is found inside of DT Swiss hubs and other hubs which use their patent for it. So first up, we'll remove the end cap. Doesn't normally come off as easy as that. I have had to just give it a little bit of persuasion. Then once we take off the free hub, you'll see there is some little serrations inside of there. Now, we've got a little spring. Then we've got two of what DT Swiss calls star ratchets. And while one of them sits inside of the actual hub shell here, inside there, you can just about see we've got ourselves some little slots there for them to actually go in. And likewise, inside of that free hub body. Then, this is where the magic really works. It's almost like a clutch plate style. So similar to what you'd have in a car if you took apart the clutch. So you can see here that these star ratchets, they're serrated on one side and then on the other side, perfectly flat. That means that when one of them goes inside of the free hub, it has the flat part against the bearing on the inside. First of all though, you need to put a little spring inside of there, because that does in fact aid engaging and disengaging of the free hub mechanism with the actual hub body itself. Then you would have these serrations line up against one another. So if you imagine this is inside of the hub shell, that's exactly what it's doing. So it's engaging and disengaging. So as you can see here, that'd be engaging, so pedaling, travel forward. As you free hub, the hub would be turning, and that's what's giving you that cool sounding noise. Now, a real advantage of this, I think, is that you've got so many different contact points here. Instead of having a 3 or 4 pull mechanism where you're only gonna have those bits engaged, here, well, we've got 36 different engagement points all at the same time. Now, another setup which is pretty similar to that of DT Swiss is this of Chris King, which will be a familiar name to many of you out there. Now, this freehub style operates in such a way that the more pressure or more force that you're applying, the tighter the engagement becomes. And I guess there's some physics in there too, which means the more power transfer you're gonna get out of it. Now, I did take this one apart because it is made of quite a few complex bits, but hopefully the images on screen right now show exactly how it works. And well, it does give you a pretty cool sound because it's got 72 points of engagement inside of there. Now, there are dozens and dozens of different freehub types, and we can't cover them all off, but finally, let's touch on the axial clutch technology found inside of some Zipp hubs. This uses the force of magnets. That's right, magnets. So, inside of the actual hub shell here, just underneath this dust cap cover, we can get to a 36-tooth ratchet mechanism. So there's 6 magnets that engage fully when you apply pressure through your pedals and onto that free hub. And then when you don't apply any pressure, when you're freewheeling, they disengage totally, meaning, that's right, that essentially you should be able to freewheel just a little bit further because you don't have the added resistance of any pulls or ratchets that are clicking into place as much. Nice little idea, that. The noise or sound of a freehub is often talked about recently because people seem to desire a different sound from what's standard. One of the suggestions to get it slightly noisier for a loud old click is to strip out all that lubricant and grease from these parts, as well as stretching the springs to try and get them to snap a little bit quicker into place to give you that loud old noise. And then on the flip side, to try and quieten them down, people packing them full of grease and then really compressing those springs, they don't tend to, well, pop back into place quite as much, and even removing retaining rings if you've got them. Now, don't do this. The reason being, it could well turn your bike into a fixed wheel because it won't have a return mechanism, not allowing you to freewheel. Then on the flip side, they become stuck down in place, meaning that the free hub turns, but it doesn't engage with the actual hub shell to drive you forward. There are some upgrades to be made though, such as with DT Swiss, they actually have replacement ratchets. So those star ratchets, you can get them with up to 54 teeth of engagement. That will give you a louder freehub, and there are other alternatives out there. So that is the only time I would ever advise doing something like that to the internals of your freehub mechanism. There we are, the humble freehub, a part of the bike which many of us often forget about, but it does a very important job. Let me know what you would like me to show you next, exactly how it works from a bicycle, because I love getting down to the nitty gritty of these components. Get involved in the comments down below, and also remember to like and share it with your friends. Share it with someone who wants a really loud freehub to warn them of the dangers of doing that, because Johnny Tex told them. Now remember to check out the GCN shop at shop.globalcyclingnetwork.com. We've got a whole heap of goodies. And now, for two more great videos, how about clicking just down here and just down here?